Ah, thanks, guys. Looking lovely. Nice to have my Fiki Zola in studio. Looking forward to their performance a little bit later on. Don't miss it. But right now, we're talking some pets, and I'm sitting down with veterinarian Dr. Rena Cotton. We're talking about some factors to consider when you want to get yourself a little puppy as a companion, because it's quite a commitment, Dr. Rena. Good morning. How are you?
Hi. Oh, good, thanks.
Lovely. I see Bob is chilling there very nicely. I must just tell you, he had a long day yesterday. He was a working dog yesterday.
Oh, good.
So you can see he's very, very relaxed. So, you know, it's lovely to have a little companion, lovely to have a little dog to come home to, but there's some certain factors that you need to consider before even going to look at getting yourself a dog. What are some of those more important factors that you would say?
Okay, the most important thing is to realize that a dog is a commitment. They can live as long as 18 years, and the puppy stage is fun and they're cute, but one needs to know that they're a member of the family, and one has a responsibility to keep them healthy and happy and mentally stimulated for a long time. When choosing a puppy, look at your lifestyle, look at your needs, and try to adapt a dog to that. If you're a very energetic person, you can get a dog that can run with you, that can exercise with you. But if you're lazy, don't go and get something that needs a lot of exercise. If you have a family, or if there's kids around or other pets, think carefully about a dog who can fit into that lifestyle.
Which is very interesting, because what you're saying is that certain type of dog breeds suit certain people and or their lifestyles.
Absolutely. Things like terriers are very active and they often don't like other
species. Get a farm
species.
When you have a terrier.
Yeah, and no chickens.
Oh, yeah, exactly. They all too. So this is some of the most important factors. Are there any misconceptions that people may have when buying a puppy, or, you know, just something that they need to really...
Well, it's always a good idea, if you have the opportunity, to look at the parents, to look at the size they're going to be. You can have a big dog who's lazy, so some big dogs don't need a lot of space, and every dog needs exercise, so even a little chihuahua needs to get out. You can get a dog like a mastiff who tends to be a lazy dog, so it does, it's not a dog that goes running with you. So if you want a big dog, a big companion, don't go and get something that, like a working dog that you have to take sledding or herding.
Exactly.
If you get yourself a husky, make sure that you up every Sunday morning sledding.
I heard they quite, you know, they need some attention, huskies especially.
Yes.
And when it comes to people having very busy lifestyles, I know working a 9-to-5 job, is it even worthwhile to try and get a companion, even though they would really want to? Can they actually?
As long as you make allowances, if you make sure that the dog is taken out. There's a lot of dog walkers around, neighbors, people who are quite happy to take the dog out. But dogs are social animals. They pack animals. They need company, whether it's human or canine. Yeah. So as long as you adapt your lifestyle and make allowances for the dog.
Because you can't expect to leave your dog, obviously, at home.
It needs to exercise at least once a day, and then it also has to go out to the toilet. So you can't just leave it locked up all day and expect it not to dirty in the house.
But I think one of the most important points is to do research about breeds.
Yes.
In terms of how they will fit into your lifestyle, correct?
Yes, absolutely. And there's no hard and fast rules, but there are certain characteristics associated with certain breeds.
Yeah. Is there a type of dog that you could, that you would say, you know, this would really suit a wide variety of people? What are some of your favorite dogs that you would say as to keep as pets? I know there's so many.
Well, my favorites are usually the rescue dogs.
Yes.
But they also come with their issues, and you don't really know what you're getting. But every dog's my favorite.
But I mean, I think you together with myself as well, we would encourage viewers out there to go to shelters and try and adopt a dog, because I think this is a great need in South Africa specifically, because there's so many dogs looking for good homes.
We have too many dogs, and part of being a responsible pet owner is to sterilize them, that we don't perpetuate the population increase.
But I think most importantly, know that it's a long-term commitment. Yes, it is not something
absolutely.
You buy today and then, you know, one or two years.
Well, if
it's
you want
over.
To get, the more you put into it, the more you benefit. And if you want to get full benefit, have the dog healthy, commit to a healthy well cared for dog, and that involves the emotional as well as the physical health.
And they will love you unconditionally.
Absolutely. No one loves you like your dog.
No one loves you like your dog. Thank you so much, Dr. Rena, for coming this morning, just giving us an eye opener this morning. So make sure, get down to maybe a shelter, go adopt a dog, but make sure that you do consider all of these factors that Dr. Rena talked about in terms of getting your dog, and that will enable you to really take care of your man's best friend. We're going to be back right after this break. Lots more to come.
Share the love with South Africa's most loved dog food, Bobtail, for strong South African dogs.